Okay, Assalamualaikum brothers and sisters. So in this video, I would like to show you on how to do DC sweep. So basically, this tutorial is trying to teach you on plotting a graph of a parameter versus another parameter instead of the standard parameter versus time. Okay, so that kind of configuration is using a simulation profile known as DC sweep. Okay, so in order to do that, I'll reuse the example in your experiment 1, which is the Ohm's law. Okay, so if you can remember, this is your circuit kan, and you are plotting the current IR3 versus the voltage across your R3, and then you calculate the slope. The slope is the conductance, and when you do the inverse of the slope, you will get the resistance R3, 6.8 kilo ohm. Okay, so I have prepared the circuit here in your PSpice, and I just put a voltage supply here around 9 volt. Just put the logical value, just like the power supply in your lab. So in your experiment 1, you want to plot the current flowing through your R3, and then you measure the voltage, and then you plot the graph of I versus V. Alright, so first thing, I'm going to create the simulation profile. So I'll go to PSpice, new simulation profile. So I'm going to call this O-Law Sim, because that's the name of my project. Okay, so I'm going to create. Okay, so this is the simulation settings. So this is the default setting. And in the tutorial for half-wave and op-amp, we use the time domain analysis. Okay, so now you want to do the DC sweep. Right, so you can see here for primary sweep analysis, the variables here are the voltage and current source. So in our circuit, we have our voltage source. So you have to key in the value of the voltage source, which is V1. Right, so I'm going to make it a linear sweep, and I'm going to basically increase your voltage supply from 0 until 9 with an increment of 0.1 volt. I know maybe you are thinking you are supposed to plot current versus VR3, right? So just bear with me. I'm going to show that later. So I'm going to apply this, right? I'm going to click OK. Now, you want to measure the current through your R3. So you can use this current marker here. So make sure you put it correctly. If you put it here, see, current marker will be ignored unless connected to a pin. So you have to put it here. At the, if you can see, you have to put it properly at the red line there near your device. Okay, for your voltage across R3, you're going to measure the voltage from this node to ground. Practically, you're going to measure, you're going to put the DMM between this node to ground, kan? So please take note on this node. The node name is 376. Okay, just remember the number there. Okay, so now I'm going to save and I'm gonna run it. Okay, this is what I get, and this is the current of your IR3, okay, but this is V1, eh? So we want to plot VR3. So what you need to do is, you click on the x-axis here, and you will see a pop-up window. So you want to set the x-axis, so it's going to be a linear scale. So this is the important point here, axis variable, okay. So once you click that, you have so many variables here, all related to our circuit. But we want to plot the voltage, kan? So we just unclick the currents and the powers and just leave the analog, the parameter and the alias names. So if you can recall back the name of the node just now, 376, let me double check. So if you move your cursor, there, 376, kan? Okay, so now I'm going to choose this node. And be careful, if you accidentally click a different node, okay? So you can see here, it keeps on compiling the parameters. So you need to be careful when you see this trace expression, right? So just make sure you choose once and that's it, right? And then you click OK, and then you click OK again. You can see the changes here in the x-axis. Now let's confirm our result. So you need to use the cursor, right? Trace, cursor, display, and you can straight away use cursor to measure the slope. Right, it chooses this point here and then create the slope, but of course you can find it here in this table here. All right, you can see I'm highlighting it here. Okay, so you can get the difference between the current is 500 micron, and basically delta I is 500 and delta V is 3.4. So if I use these values to calculate the slope, I will get 0.5 milliampere divided by 3.4 volt, 0.147 millisiemens. I believe that's what you get in your experiment 1. And when you invert this slope, you will get the resistance 6.8 kilo ohm. So this is how you plot the graph. Okay. So firstly, you need to choose the DC sweep analysis and sweep the voltage supply. However, you need to choose the correct parameter that you want to plot with the voltage supply. In this case, you are choosing this current flowing through your artery. Of course, it's the same current, but just to make it more specific, I want the current through your artery. Okay. And then you click the x-axis and choose the actual voltage that you want to. In order to do that, you need to identify what is the value of the node. Okay, so that's it. That's how you can present your DC sweep. So for example, if you need to plot your diode current versus your diode voltage, it is the same concept. Okay, so that's it. Thank you. Assalamualaikum. Bye.